ओके क्लास टेंथ, लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद आवर लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7, थ्योरीज ऑफ डिमांड, दैट इज काइंड्स ऑफ डिमांड. फर्स्ट इज प्राइस डिमांड. द प्राइस डिमांड रिफर्स टू वेरियस क्वांटिटीज ऑफ अ कमोडिटी और सर्विसेज दैट आर परचेज्ड एट अ गिवन टाइम एंड एट अ गिवन प्राइसेज फ्रॉम द मार्केट. इन लेमैन लैंग्वेज इफ आई एक्सप्लेन यू प्राइस डिमांड, इट मीन्स द डिमांड of the commodity which is demanded with increase or decrease in the prices, which means that if the prices are going to increase, our demand is going to decrease, and if our prices is going to decrease, our demand is going to increase. Okay, it is inversely proportional. Prices are inversely proportional with the demand. Price demand has inverse relationship with the price. Inverse relationship means that if the prices of the commodity increases, okay, listen it very carefully. If the prices of the commodity increases, its quantity demanded decreases. And as the price decreases, the quantity increases. Correct? So this is price demand. Next is income demand. Income demand means it is now over here income and quantity demanded are directly related to each other. Means if our income is increasing, demand will also increase. If our income is decreasing, demand will also decrease. Correct? Listen it very carefully, children. It is very important topic. Under such conditions, with the increase in income, a consumer may purchase increased quantity of the commodity even though there may not be fall in the price. Why? Because now he wants to treat himself as a superior. Now he wants to, and he can, and he is willing to move from inferior goods to normal goods. Correct? From inferior goods to normal goods. So therefore he will increase his demand with an increase in his income. And if by chance there is a decrease in the income, his demand for the commodity will also decrease. Correct? Turn the page now, come to joint demand. When several items are demanded together for one particular purpose, such demand is known as joint demand. Children, with the name itself, you must be understanding that joint demand means that A plus B plus C means if I want to make coffee, okay, if I want to have coffee, so I will require what? Firstly, I will require require coffee powder. Then I will also require milk. If you want to have black coffee, then you will require what? You will require water and you will require sugar. So demand for all these items have increased due to what? Due to increase in the demand of coffee. So this is what? This is joint demand. When products or when commodities are demanded in order to satisfy or fulfill our demand for one commodity, that is known as joint demand, because all these are demanded jointly. Correct? Next is derived demand or direct demand. Now, direct demand or derived demand means when I want commodities to build something or for the production of one commodity. Example, let's read from the book only. When demand for a good X, generally raw material, is dependent on the demand for another commodity, which is generally our finished product or finished commodity, then this is known as derived demand. Okay, then this is known as derived demand or direct demand. Now let's see this example. We want to construct a building. Now for building, I need several things like bricks, cement, sand, timber, iron. Demand for all these items is derived demand, and demand for building ultimate commodity is direct demand. Clear? I hope so. Sixth, next is composite demand. Composite demand, let's read. A commodity can be used for several purposes and its demand is directly linked to its various uses. I'm repeating once again. A commodity can be used for several purposes, multiple purpose of a commodity, and its demand is directly related to its various uses. Such a demand is known as composite demand. Let us see the example now. Example, milk. I am demanding for milk. Okay. And I can use milk for any purpose, for any reason I can use. I can use it for making my tea or coffee. I can use it for butter, cheese, curd, or even ghee. Correct? I can use it for sweets, or I can use it for my direct consumption. Alright. So, demand for milk is composite demand. Like example, electricity. Electricity. You demand for electricity. Now, with electricity, what you can do? You can do many things. Okay, we can do many things. Like example, we can run our ACs, fans, we can also run our microwaves, ovens, we can watch movies. If electricity is not there, then it is a very big problem for us. So electricity is what? Demand for electricity is composite demand. And it has multiple or various uses. Correct? Now with this, we finished with our chapter number 7, class 10. Very important chapter it is. Almost every point, almost every topic I have covered with you. Correct? Go through this chapter. Go through the topics that I have discussed with you. Any problem, any confusion, please come up to me. Alright? Because this is a very important topic. Again and again, I'm emphasizing on it. This is a very important chapter. So, let me know if you have any problem, if you have any confusion. Correct? Till then, bye-bye. Take care.